So now hopefully you can see that when you call malloc, what's really going on under the hood is that it is creating an allocation of virtual memory for your system. There is a distinction that we haven't made up to this point of private versus shared regions. So most of the memory that you've worked with so far is private, and the changes are only seen by the owner, including these small variable size regions called the heap. But there are also some shared regions where the changes are seen by all processes, and this is usually in the address space between the heap and the stack. Multiple virtual addresses map to the same physical address here. So you may have one copy of a library, for instance, and all the processes are using that same copy of the library. And so if there are changes to it, then those changes will be seen by all processes. And so usually this is only done for read-only memory, like shared libraries. So here's a picture of a more sophisticated picture of what a process address space looks like. And you can see the data regions that we have been talking about before, the code region. We have the heap, which kind of grows upwards in memory. We have the stack, which grows downwards in memory. And now we can see that there is this memory mapped region in between for shared libraries. And then we'll also observe at this point that the kernel actually reserves the higher address spaces in memory for use for its own purposes. So the operating system maintains a separate page table for every process. This provides consistency for the program, so it can always count on things being the same physical addresses. So for instance, code generally begins at a particular address. It simplifies loading because you don't actually have to load data from disk until you actually need it, which is even a little more efficient than we do in P2, where we go ahead and load everything even though we may not need everything. It streamlines library sharing because you can have one copy of some of these core system libraries like libc and the math library so that you don't have to have multiple copies in memory at any given time. It also simplifies memory allocation because malloc doesn't have to find these large contiguous chunks of physical memory. It can allocate a contiguous addresses in the virtual memory space, but then those different various portions of that could map to different places in physical memory. And this improves security because processes can't see or edit each other's address spaces as long as they are private regions. So virtual memory works well if a program has good locality, especially temporal locality. So this is a really compelling reason to design for that. It also works really well if a program has a working set that fits in main memory. So all of the data that's needed for a particular calculation is small enough to fit inside of main memory. If this is not true, then the system is going to need to continuously swap pages in and out of disk. And this is extremely expensive, and it's called thrashing. This is a significant cause of poor program performance at large scales, and this can be detected using instruments called profilers. And it does this by counting the number of page faults that occur while a program is running. Okay, so we are now into our final module. For the rest of the semester, we're going to continue discussing some of these operating systems principles. And the general story here is that these layers of abstraction that the OS provides simplify development. So the app developers don't have to worry about, for instance, managing physical memory. They can just use the virtual memory system provided by the OS. And that makes the app developers' lives much easier. And so the theme here is that system software is a foundation for all of the other kinds of software that you might run on a modern computing system. If this material is interesting to you, then I would strongly urge you to consider taking CS450 as your advanced systems elective, where you will dive into much greater detail than we were going to be able to do in this class.